From the WLOE and WMYN News and Public Affairs Department, this is Community Accents, connecting Rockingham County people, businesses, and services, recorded live on location and broadcast Monday through Friday at 8:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. Video production funding provided by the Rockingham County Business and Technology Center. Entrepreneur-focused, technology-enabled, future-driven.
Good morning, Rockingham County and the world. This is Dr. Jean Steverson. We are glad to be with you today. I am Assistant Superintendent for Rockingham County Schools, and I have a couple of guests with me today. We're going to talk about a very exciting program that is going on within Rockingham County Schools, and it is called Gear Up. As we start talking about Gear Up and what it is, I'd like to go ahead and let my guests introduce themselves today. Mavis?
Good morning. My name is Mavis Dillon, and I am a Gear Up student coordinator, and I serve Reedsville Middle School, Reedsville High School, and Western Rockingham Middle School.
My name is Deshonda Hampton-Simmons. I'm a Gear Up student coordinator as well, and I service Holmes Middle School, Michael High School, and Moorhead High School.
And we know we use the term gear up a lot, ladies, mm-hmm. getting ourselves excited, getting ourselves going. But gear up, as we're going to talk about it today, is a little bit different. Let's start with what it is actually an acronym. Mm-hmm. And so the letters mean something special. Let's talk about what that, what the actual meaning is and what the words represent.
Well, the words are simple. They stand for Gaining Early Awareness for Readiness Program for Undergraduate Students. So it's basically a program targeted towards students starting college and matriculating through high school and going to college and graduating successfully.
Okay, very good. So we will talk a little bit more about it later, but the one of the most exciting things is that we're starting with 7th graders, mm-hmm. and we're working with 12th graders this year. Trying to, again, get them ready for college, but also for careers. And sometimes when we talk about college, mm-hmm. people are getting people ready for college, they think only college, mm-hmm. and they think maybe only a four-year college. Mm-hmm. We're actually helping students at all levels of ability, all levels of financial income, with varying academic levels, but we're trying to boost all of those things and help them find the resources so that they can be successful for two-year college, four-year college, careers in general. Is that your understanding as well?
Yes, it is.
Okay, great. So we know that Gear Up provides data-driven programs based on programs that have been tried elsewhere. They are validated programs, and we know that we are providing resources to a number of students as we go. So what are some of the services that Gear Up provides?
This year, with it being our first year in our federal grant, we have provided some tutoring services, after-school tutoring and Saturday school tutoring. We've also provided college tours, where the students are able to meet with an admissions officer and tour campus and actually have lunch on the campus in the dining facility. The college tours have been very beneficial, mm-hmm. for 7th grade students and for our seniors. One exciting trip that Ms. Hampton Simmons and I participated in, we were able to take 30 students, seniors, to ECU along with probably 10 parents, yes. and we spent the night in Greenville, mm-hmm. and the kids had a wonderful experience on the Friday when they were there with ECU admissions officer, and actually some of the students were accepted, mm-hmm. Into the college, mm-hmm. while they were there on their college visit day. And I thought that was very rewarding to the students and to the program.
It was.
That sounds great. Now, did you mention 7th graders?
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. 7th graders have been allowed, or they have participated in college visits. We actually organized, and we actually had every 7th grader, at Holmes Middle School, mm-hmm. Western Rockingham, and Reedsville Middle. Mm-hmm. They all attended or visited a college.
A college, at least three colleges, mm-hmm. between all campuses.
And the three colleges that assisted us with that was Salem College, mm-hmm. and Winston-Salem State University, mm-hmm. and A&T. Mm-hmm.
And in fact, I know that Rockingham Middle School students also went. Their seventh graders visited UNC Chapel Hill. So all of our seventh graders have been to on our college campus, those who were able to go at that time. There's some people who don't understand or know why we are taking seventh grade students. They're not quite college ready yet. So why are we working with students in seventh grade?
There is a study called the Middle School Moment that indicates data that says that the earlier you start intervention with students, the more successful they'll be to go on to college and graduate to actually participate and have a career versus a regular 9-to-5 job. So we do believe that Gear Up starts the initiative early so that we have earlier success rates.
And kind of going along with that, I think there's an agreement among educators that teachers especially kind of know who our kids are who are at risk, that is at risk of dropping out or at risk of not being successful early on. And it's not all about academic ability or native ability. It's about motivation and engagement and wanting to stay in school.
Exactly.
So let's talk about specific grades that are served by Gear Up. That's sort of an odd combination, 7th grade and 12th grade.
Well, as the grant continues along the 7 years, next year we will continue with our 7th graders, 7th grade students as they move to the 8th grade, and then we'll also serve the rise in 7th grade and then the rise in 12th grade. And each year along the 7 years, we will add grade levels to the pool or to the cohort of the students that we serve. So it's actually starting this year with just the seventh graders, but that seventh grade group, we will have the pleasure of working with them over the next 7 years, plus the year once they finish high school, their first year in college, we will also work with them and see how successful they are in their first year of college. So it is an odd combination at the beginning of the grant, but the grant has stability as you work and add grade levels along the seven-year program.
Okay, and so you mentioned grant. And one of the questions I think a lot of people would have is, where's the money for this coming from? So, Ms. Hampton Simmons, you want to talk a little bit about the grant itself and what we can expect in the future from that?
Oh, the grant is a part of an initiative that's actually a federal initiative to empower schools to be able to have their students succeed. The money has come from also matches, local partners, and also the federal government. So we do have restrictions with what we can and cannot do with the monies, but they are for the students in their progress to college.
Okay. So let me kind of summarize what I've heard and make sure that I've got it straight. So Gear Up starts with seventh grade students, students and seniors, and then we're going to follow those. We know our seniors will be graduating and moving on, but we're also going to take those seventh graders and follow them through their graduation year and beyond, when you're beyond. So students who are in seventh grade right now have the advantage of 7 years
the
of actual
program.
Service.
Program. Yes.
That's fantastic. And so we're providing for them academic assistance through tutoring. Are you talking one-on-one tutoring here?
It's a combination, one-on-one and small group tutoring sessions.
Okay.
And mentorship as well. We'll mentor them with high school students who are in 12th grade, as well as having mentors within the building to help them and assist them with their academics.
Okay. And I want us to come back to mentoring, and maybe that'll be a part of our second half of the program, because when we talk about mentoring, we need people to help us mentor students. So very good then. Let's move on a little bit. We're coming to the end of the school year. So are we anticipating that we'll lose these kids over the summer, or what are the plans for working with them through the summer, if any?
We have worked very hard over the last month organizing a summer enrichment program, and we're going to have actually three sites this summer. One will be at McMichael High School, where we will work with our Western Rock students and our McMichael students, and then we'll have site at Moorhead, where we'll work with the Humms and the Moorhead students, and Reidsville High will be the site for the Reidsville Middle and Reidsville High students. And this summer enrichment program is truly going to be enrichment. Mm-hmm. It's not what you consider a summer school. Mm-hmm. It's going to be summer enrichment, where we'll have opportunities for students again to go and see some mm-hmm. real world activities, mm-hmm. problem solving, inquiry based activities. Mm-hmm. We've got a CSI week scheduled where students will do investigate mm-hmm. Crimes and actually participate in something as far as a crime scene investigation. We have Elon University. They are providing a college visit for the Reidsville Middle students. Mm-hmm. We also have worked and discussed a partnership with the Mayo River State Park, and that's going to be something exciting that all three sites will actually visit for the entire day during the week. RCC is also going to assist us with the program as far as a walk and talk tour, and we hope to also incorporate the museum in Wentworth on the same day. So we have a lot of activities scheduled for the three-week program. Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. This sounds very exciting. Mm-hmm. Can everybody come to this program? Can everybody participate? Or are we limited in the numbers of people that we can serve?
We're looking for all levels of learners to participate in the program, for middle school and for high school. But we're looking at a target area from 25 to 30 students per site for each grade or grade level, for rising 7th graders and rising 8th graders.
Okay. So we do have a limited number of students that we will be serving.
Yes, we do.
Okay. And will there be programs for seniors as well?
Yes, there will.
Yes.
Okay.
The program for our senior students will have three different components. We'll actually have one section where the students, if they need one credit to graduate, we're hoping that we'll have students that will acknowledge that and participate in an APEX recovery credit and earn that credit and graduate before the end of June. We'll also have a leadership component that will be for students that maybe need assistance or need something, a little bump before they start that senior English and work on that senior project. Those students could come and have assistance with that. Also, if they have advanced functions, and maybe math is not their strongest suit, but we know that the requirements now have changed as far as your four maths, we'll offer a program where students could come and have a bridge course that would assist them and get their feet wet as far as being ready for advanced functions or algebra mm-hmm. too. So we've got an academic focus along with some leadership programs, and then of course going to see some colleges.
Okay, that sounds really exciting. Mm-hmm. And I think right now the focus is on finding those students who will benefit from mm-hmm. becoming engaged through these activities, mm-hmm. Receiving some academic boost, if you will, mm-hmm. but also exploring both the local environment, it sounds like, and also getting out of the area and getting on a college campus again, including RCC, which mm-hmm. of course is a great resource for us here within the county. That's excellent. Sounds very good. And those students who are able to attend will be very fortunate, I think.
Yes.
How should parents who are listening to us find out more about these programs what's available?
Each school has the actual flyer on the website posted for parents to contact teachers and reference the applications. Mm-hmm. We'll also have applications going out to each site school on this Thursday. So parents can actually call into the school and receive applications as well from Gear Up Student Coordinators.
Okay. All righty. And so you all are the contacts primarily
yes.
for these programs. That sounds great. And we're about to go to break, but before we do, let me ask you both to identify yourselves once again so that people have the opportunity to maybe make a note of your name if they're interested in contacting you.
Okay, my name is Ms. Hampton Simmons. I am the student group coordinator for Holmes Middle School, McMichael High School, and Moorhead High School.
My name is Mavis Dillon, and I'm the student coordinator for Western Rockingham Middle School, Reedsville Middle School, and Reedsville High School.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
We are going to go to break for just a minute, and when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about this, but we're going to also talk about the family and the community and how we need their help to make this a program that continues for all of our students. So we're, again, going to take a moment for station identification. This is Jean Bullock Steverson, Rockingham County Schools. It's a pleasure having you, ladies.
Likewise.
Video production funding provided by the Rockingham County Business and Technology Center. Entrepreneur-focused, technology-enabled, future-driven. Visit our website for additional information, rockinghambusiness.org.
WLOE Eden. WMYN Mandan. Listen online all the time. RockinghamCountyRadio.com.
Good morning. This is Jean Bullock Steverson again from Rockingham County Schools, and I have as my guest today some of our Gear Up staff from the school system. We are adding at the moment Ms. Rhonda Pass, and Mavis Dillon is back with us. Rhonda, how about introducing yourself to our audience and telling us a little bit about what you do?
My name is Rhonda Pass, and I work as the Gear Up Family and Community Facilitator. I serve Reedsville High School, Reedsville Middle School, and Western Rock Middle School. And part of my job is to go out into the community and kind of connect school, community, and family together.
And that's an extremely important piece of this job because, as I tell people, we don't have many students who don't have parents or someone who plays a parenting role, and we don't have much parent involvement where they're not students involved as well. So that's an important piece. But you mentioned only three of the schools that we're talking about today. So I will just point out to the audience that we are currently short of one of our parent and community facilitators. So our ladies here are kind of pulling double and triple duty. This is our first year with the Gear Up program for Rockingham County Schools, and we are learning as we go. We are growing with the program, and we've had some good community involvement and some great parent involvement, and we're going to talk about some other things that we need to go along with that. So let's see whether you all can tell us a little bit about local partners. Do we currently have local partners?
Yes, we do have local partners in the Eden area, Western Rock area, and the Reedsville area. And some of those partners consist of our YMCAs in Reedsville and Eden, state employee credit unions, Boys and Girls Club, some of our local restaurants, McDonald's, Biscuitville, mm-hmm. and these are places that have allowed us to either come in or either have donated to our program.
Mm-hmm. And I know there are others also. We've
yes.
enjoyed pizza from a variety of places,
yes.
so, or I shouldn't say I have because I've gotten none of it, although I like to eat, but uh-huh. it is indeed for our students, so that is great. And I know our goal is to grow those relationships because we're talking about a major investment here, and I do want to point out that we're talking basically $5 million to fund this program, but half of that must be matched by the school system or the community, and so therefore we are looking at all sorts of donors and all sorts of relationships. I do want to point out also that when we talk about matching, we're not talking about necessarily giving us goods. We're talking about time. And so how are we going about soliciting time from our parents or from our school staffs? What are we doing there to get that buy-in?
Well, as I mentioned earlier, we have had a tutoring program at Reedsville High School since February, and we were able to contract with a math teacher and an English teacher. But a lot of kids were coming in and needed help in business classes. They needed help with Spanish, mm-hmm. chemistry, and so forth. And actually, since February, for the month of February and March, we actually had 65 hours of volunteer from the teachers there.
That's amazing.
That's a match, but that's also a proving that there's sustainability in this program, that once the grant is completed after the 7 years, we have teachers that have vested into the concept of giving those kids mm-hmm. some individual assistance and also giving them a little extra time right before the grading period or right before the midterm grades are reported, that they can come in and they can get extra help. And I think that's valuable.
Yeah. I want to just give kudos to those teachers who are volunteering and their administrators volunteering yes. along with them. It's a very, very busy time for teachers, and the goals and the vision for Rockingham County Schools are broad and great, and it's to bring all of our students along and to push them as far as they can go. So our teachers are already, they have a full plate. So for them to come in on Saturday and volunteer hours or volunteer even to be reimbursed at a low rate for helping our students is tremendous. Mm-hmm. So I just want to applaud that. And I'm not so much interested right now in the specific donations of goods per se, especially food, but what else can the community do to help us with this process?
From a perspective of inviting us in, that's one of the main things. If community partners, churches, businesses would just invite Gear Up program and Gear Up staff in to offer information, mm-hmm. Providing opportunities for our 12th grade students as well as our middle school students to come in and maybe visit your business, some job shadowing opportunities, or even, you know, volunteering some time mm-hmm. to come into the school system to speak to some of our students about the various careers and the different jobs that we have here in Rockingham County.
And I think that's really important. I know that one of the Gear Up goals is job shadowing, so that our students actually get to see what mom does at work or what dad does at work, right. or somebody whose work I don't know, maybe the radio exactly. staff or the owners of that. So we're looking again to help people formulate ideas for careers and figure out how school can play a part in that. Job shadowing, then, is something that we really want to encourage. Are there any jobs that we wouldn't want? I mean, I guess my point that I would like to make is that that's something everybody can do, whether you're small or large. If we can yeah. bring our students to see what you're doing and what's required, mm-hmm. it may make their education a lot more meaningful for them. We don't always understand why we have to take algebra, you know.
Right.
But when we can see it at work, it makes a difference for our students, I think.
Yeah.
Okay. Are there specific kinds of things as a parent and community facilitator, Rhonda, that you see a need for or things that are going on in that area?
What I'm seeing is that we're doing a great job for us to Gear Up staff and Rockingham County Schools of getting the program going within our schools mm-hmm. and helping our students. But we also need to help our parents so that they can help their students. So I think that, you know, even allowing opportunities for some of our parents to do some of those things and visit RCC campuses and visit college campuses and open the door for them to kind of have college tours and do some job shadowing and helping them with extra educational tools also. So if we help the parents and if the community helps the parents help the students, then we have also helped our community.
So are you saying parents could go on college tours as well?
Absolutely.
Oh,
absolutely.
Wonderful. That's exciting. And I know that financial aid, especially in this economy, is a big concern for parents. Do you have a way to help them with that?
With the financial aid, what we have done is we do various workshops throughout the year, and we invite some of the financial aid officers from various colleges to come in, and they speak with parents as well as students about the various options that they have at their school, loans, scholarships, and ways to apply, going through the FAFSA. Not only that, we have our college advisors
yes.
in our high schools, and they have been a great help in far as with our Gear Up program and helping the students and the parents kind of fill out the FAFSA, offering them all information about scholarships. So any financial aid questions or information that is needed, they can see Gear Up staff or our college advisors.
And that's a great thing. I know that our college advisors have been a tremendous resource for the county, and I just wanted to kind of point out that our scholarships have risen from the $5 million range about 4 or 5 years ago to over $18 million. Big numbers, $18 million last year, and we're certainly hoping for more. A lot of that is the work of our school staffs, yes, but also our college advisors and now our Gear Up staff as well. So it's important that we work together in a collaborative way with them. I just want to point out also that I know we've used a lot of staff members from Rockingham Community College to assist us with our parent nights and financial information, and also the College Foundation of North Carolina has been involved with us and is working to pass on that information.
Yes. Okay. Matter of fact, we had a Breezeville High School had a workshop last night, and Derek Satterfield from Rockingham Community College, and we also had representatives from Elon College and North Carolina A&T that spoke with parents about admissions, financial aid, and some of the final things that they had questions about. These students have already been accepted, so parents had questions about what to do now, and so we had college people on board right there to answer those questions for those parents.
That's fantastic. That's great assistance. And I know, too, that we're trying to pull from all areas of the county. There's no one group that we don't need information or support from. What about the faith-based community? Is that an audience that we're seeking as well?
Most definitely. We are seeking faith-based community assistance. People go to church. And our parents, as well as our students, go to church. So I would like to say that, you know, the Eden Ministerial Alliance has allowed Gear Up to come in, and we did a workshop there, which was very successful. But it's not just limited to ministerial alliances. We would, you know, love to come into just individual churches to offer information, to speak with parents, students, not just 12th graders, middle school, to offer information, and then, you know, to seek mentoring.
Right.
We would love for some of our faith base to, you know, step up and say that, you know, I would love to mentor some of your students.
Well, we definitely have that need for mentoring. Our parents are not always available for various reasons to help their kids. And if they're like my kids, it's always easier coming from someone other than a parent when we need that assistance. So this is an open invitation to our community to talk to us and to see how they can be of assistance. And again, we're looking for everybody, no matter what their rank or role within the county, because there are ways that we can help. So just kind of, again, to recap, we are looking for ways to continue our program beyond the 7 years of the grant. And we're trying to build those relationships both within the school with our teachers and students, but also in the community. And when we talk about the community, we're talking about all aspects of the community. Yes. Our summer program with parks and recreation and...
there's also a parent piece in our summer enrichment program.
Okay.
Where we're going to have offer various meetings, informal meetings, either in the morning, in the afternoon, or later in the evening, about what's available at the college level, at the career level, and what we're asking of the students, and what we're asking for the parents to support. So the parent involvement piece in the summer enrichment, I think, will be a valuable partnership, because because we will be there at extended hours, and will be available for parents when they're available.
Exactly.
I think that's wonderful. So if a parent or a community agency or individuals want to say, you know, what can I do? How can I help? How do they get that information? What's the best resource for them, or the best way for them to contact us?
Most of the schools that we serve have Gear Up on their website, and they have our contact information. Would you not say, Rhonda?
Yes, yes. And they can also call the school, any of our target schools that we've mentioned today, and they can ask, you know, anyone there, because we're very familiar, everyone's very familiar with Gear Up, and they can ask who the contact person is at that particular school, and they will give either my name, Mavis Dillon, or Deshonda Hampton Simmons.
Okay. Very good. Well, that kind of brings us to a close. Our time is up, but I just want to kind of reemphasize that Gear Up is a program aimed at getting our students ready academically, ready in terms of knowledge base about colleges and careers, and helping their parents understand also the resources that are available to them.
We really want to make Rockingham County a college-going culture. That is our main goal for Gear Up.
And as we move toward that, the roles that you ladies have and our community partners, is just an invaluable one. And so we appreciate what you're doing already and look forward to having the community join us as we move forward toward building that college-going culture. This is Jean Steverson, Rockingham County Schools, and we want to thank you for the opportunity to be here today.